in verband met de herdenking van de 70ste dag van de Republiek India heeft vicepresident Michael Ashwin Adhin een receptie van de Indiase ambassade bijgewoond. Op 26 januari 1949 trad ook de Indiase grondwet in werking.
I most gratefully, warmly welcome all of you to the celebration of the 70th Republic Day of India this evening. On behalf of government and people of India, and my colleagues in the embassy and Swami Vivekanand Cultural Center, permit me to take this opportunity to wish all of you and the nation of Suriname a happy, progressive, and constructive New Year 2019. Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, this is the day on which the father of the nation, Mahatma Gandhi, declared the independence of India in 1930, 17 years before India was returned to Indians. After we raised our tricolor national flag on August 15, 1947, the Constituent Assembly of India, after 2.5 years of discussion and debate, gave India its constitution, the Holy Book of Indian Governance, which is a Magna Carta of socio-economic transformation of the country, representing the hopes and aspirations of our inherited and shared diversity of today, 1.3 billion people belonging to three major ethnic groups, Aryans, Mongoloids, and Dravidians, to the health and happiness of His Excellency, the President of the Republic of Suriname, to the peace, progress, and prosperity of the people of Suriname, and to the abiding friendship and cooperation between India and Suriname.
इस तरह भारतीय संस्कृति और भारतीय सभ्यता का प्रदर्शन करना आपकी प्रस्तुति में भी प्रशंसनीय है। It is praiseworthy to mention the way that the ambassador has a lot of ideas to promote the civilization and the culture that comes from India. The names that he has expounded today to hear are names that resonate in our history. With very great example of life's life history and life's experiences. I am deeply proud to address you today on behalf of His Excellency Desiree Delano Bouterse, our President of the Republic of Suriname, on this auspicious occasion of the commemoration of this historic event, being the Republic Day marking the birth of the sovereign and democratic Republic of India, being the most and the greatest, the biggest democratic republic in the world. 7 decades ago, on January 26, 1949, the Indian Constitution was adopted, guided by the basic principles of the rule of law and righteousness of every citizen. Every citizen's democratic values and norms, which are pivotal for a balanced social economic development. The ideals enshrined in this constitution, in your constitution of India, should therefore continue to be leading and be the leading principle for disseminating and fostering the thoughts of freedom, democracy, prosperity, and well-being for the benefit of the people of the Republic of India and across the region. In commemorating this momentous event, the historical bond of both our countries is memorized and celebrated, a bond that reflects itself and dates back to the time immigrants from India arrived in Suriname. Surmounting the ills of the colonial times, the Republic of Suriname and the Republic of India have chosen the path to a healthy, interdependent relationship, underpinned by the principles of mutual respect and benefit. Up to date, the strong presence of Indian descendants and their contribution to the political, economic, social and cultural development in Suriname is witnessed and greatly acknowledged. Ambassador, ladies and gentlemen, on January 23rd this year, the Republic of Suriname and the Republic of India have commemorated 43 years of the establishment of diplomatic relations. Over the past decades, our common history, long-standing, mutual, beneficial relationship has resulted in fruitful cooperation in many areas. This relationship has continued to prosper with a deep sense of respect and solidarity, which not only reflects itself through our genuine South-South partnership, but also underlines our partnerships and efforts in multilateral affairs and international fora. The state visit of His Excellency Ram Nath Kovind to Suriname in June 2018 and the intended reciprocal visit of His Excellency Desiree Delano Bouterse later this year to India are testimony of our commitment to bring the existing relations to greater heights, as both our countries are destined to further substantiate and strengthen the existing ties. I wish to express President Bouterse's sincere appreciation for India's involvement, assistance, and commitment as it relates to the implementation of several agreements reached during this visit of President Ram Nath Kovind and the follow-up actions already taken. In addition, to the above, the government of Suriname looks forward to welcome the Minister of External Affairs, His Excellency Sushma Swaraj, to Suriname later this year, as well as to convene the 7th Joint Commission meeting between our countries in order to further collaborate on matters of common interest discussed during various high-level arrangements. Ambassador, ladies and gentlemen, Suriname considers India to be an important international actor, of which its role in global geopolitics should be recognized as crucial, in particular within the International Solar Alliance, ISA, and other major international initiatives towards maintaining peace and security in the world while advancing substantial development.